There are some people who talk about jihad and they say that they please Allah by slandering the kuffar, calling them swines, ugly kafirs, and things like that. And they say that they are allowed to do this because Allah says in the Quran that the kuffar are worse than swines and pigs. And so they are actually saying that they are making a compliment to the kuffar by calling them
swines. First of all, in the Quran Kareem, Allah does not say kuffar are worse than swines and pigs. And I don't know what Quran they're talking about, but the Quran we know, it doesn't say that. Secondly, me as a Muslim, my responsibility, my true jihad towards the kafir is to bring him to the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. That's my first jihad. Then if he doesn't accept the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you've got another issue, okay? Talk about the other jihad. But till now you haven't even started the first thing. Bring people to the deen of Allah. Speak to people about the deen of Allah. Allah tells you your first jihad is to bring people to the deen of Allah. Then your second jihad is to fight, you know, the oppression and injustice of others. But you haven't even done the first thing. How do you jump to the second thing? How are you going to justify that in front of Allah Azza wa Jal? You can't justify that. Your first jihad in front of Allah is to invite people to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ud'u ila sabili rabbika bil hikmati wal maw'idhati al hasana. Call people to the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal with wisdom and the best of speech. That's your first jihad. Implement this first jihad, then see how big of a mujahid for you for the second jihad. But you are trying to run away from the first jihad by talking about the second jihad because you can't do either the first or the second. Because if you could do the big jihad, then you could do that small jihad. That's a reality. If someone is fit to Allah to go and fight on the battlefield as they claim they are, then do the first jihad and bring people to the deen of Allah. Invite people to the deen of Allah. Kafir, kafir, kafir. All the companions were kuffar. All the companions were kuffar. What? Well, you know they're all swines and pigs too? Is that what we call them? Did the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam wish killing them? The Nabi sallallahu alaihi wanted to bring him. The Nabi made dua for Umar ibn al-Khattab and Abu Jahl when they were the biggest enemies to Islam. He made dua for them. Why is your heart full of hatred and the heart of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is full of love? Why doesn't our heart become like the heart of the Prophet alaihi salatu wasallam? The Nabi's heart was not a heart full of love, hatred. His heart was full of love. But these people that talk about kuffar, pig, swine, this, that, their hearts are full of hatred. There's a difference between, you're not following the Prophet ﷺ here. Why don't you follow the true character of the Prophet ﷺ? A man that his heart was full of love and wishing care and love for everyone else. That's the Prophet ﷺ. But those who, you know, have hatred towards everyone, these people have personal issues. They have personal issues. Because the Nabi ﷺ wasn't like that. And there is no way the Prophet ﷺ was like that. The Nabi ﷺ used to sit down amongst the Sahaba and say, this, you know, kuffar, pigs, dogs, swines. Is that the character of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam? That's not his character. The only character on earth that does that are gangsters. So why are we acting like gangsters, not acting like the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam? If we truly claim that we follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, well, then you follow him. You're not following him. Those people who act like that, you're not acting like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam. So how do you expect the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam to take you jihad with him when you don't even act like him? You act like his enemies. You act like his enemies. You're acting, you know, that attitude, you know, pigs, swine, dogs, this, that's the attitude of the enemies of Islam. So we act like the enemies of Islam, and then when we fight the enemies of Islam, when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not even act that way. That's not the character of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's not the manners of the Prophet alayhi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's not the morals of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that's not even Islam or the da'wah of Islam or what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with. Wallahi, that's not the Prophet alayhi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah describes him to be rahmah. Allah says in the Quran al-Karim about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We sent you as a mercy to mankind. That means what? The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is rahmah, and at the same time he came to kill people. That contradicts what Allah says in the Quran. That's contradicting what Allah says in the Quran. How could the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam be rahmah to people and at the same time he's killing them? That's not rahmah. But in rahmah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the mercy he had is that he wished Islam for everyone. And if we really want to practice jihad, practice jihad by inviting people to the deen of Allah. That's jihad. Do something that you can do right now. You have a practical jihad in your life now. The practical jihad in your life that you implement Islam in your life and invite people to Islam. Let us see if you implement that. Implement that now, then we'll talk about the other jihad. But the reality is, we are weak in implementing that, and we are not only weak in it, we can't even do the other jihad at all. So let us be practical, let's do the jihad that we can do right now, and that's by practicing Islam in our lives, the manners of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in our lives, and bringing people and show people the beauty of this beautiful religion that Allah azza wa jal saved mankind with.
show.